Hey now, Rodney R. Dixon here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to open up an optical drive, an internal optical drive in a computer, that is to say, CD-ROM, DVD-ROM, CD writer, DVD burner, DVD recorder, whatever you want to call them, even perhaps modern Blu-ray drives, not entirely sure. Anyway, in this example, I'm opening up an LG Super Multi DVD drive, model GSA4163B, which is a DVD writer. Now, what's important is, in order to open up one of these optical drives, you must first disengage the disk tray. If the disk tray is closed, there's a locking mechanism which will most likely hold the front plate, the front fascia, in place, which will prevent proper opening up of the optical drive. So, it's recommended that you begin by first disengaging the lock on the disk tray. Of course, the easiest way to do it is to provide a power feed to your optical drive, open up the disk tray, and then disconnect it from the power feed. That's the easiest way. Or if not, most optical drives have a lock disengage hole, which you could use something such as a paper clip or a pin or a thin nail to push through, to which will in fact not only unlock the mechanism but cause a gear to push the tray out a tiny bit, which will allow you to disengage it. Once the tray is disengaged, what you have to do is you have to disengage the front fascia. Now in this case, this front fascia was binded by clips, as you can see, clip here, clip here, clip here, using, I don't have it on hand, but using a flat slot screwdriver, I was able to pry these guys open and disengage the front panel, the front cover. From there, what you have to do is you have to disengage the four screws at the bottom of the casing, the housing. Four simple screws, in this case it is your standard X or cross pattern, which you use, you know, your standard screwdriver, and disengage all four. Once that is done, it's important to note that you don't open it as so with the device on its back, but rather you turn it back forward so that it is lying down as intended on the table or surface, with the front fascia disengaged, with the tray open. From there, you can simply remove the top metal cover, which as you can see has a clasp which will hold the disc in place, as this spindle motor mechanism will come up to pin the disc when reading. And from here, within the internals of your optical drive, you could perform some maintenance tasks, such as cleaning the laser eye with the, I recommend, Q-tip and rubbing alcohol if it's dirty, if you're having problems reading discs. Perhaps readjust the gear mechanisms if they're not engaging and disengaging properly. Perhaps grease them up if they require lubricant. And, of course, you could get into some advanced mechanical and electrical maintenance if you know how. I myself do not know how. It's as simple as that. Once you're good to go, what you can do is, of course, you can repeat the process in reverse. That is to say, place the top cover back in place until it fits nicely in its grooves. It has a indicated and predefined placement where it will lock comfortably in place. And then from there, of course, you can snap, well, you could bind the top cover onto the rest of the chassis with your mounting screws. Once that's done, you could snap your front plate, front cover, front fascia, whatever you want to call it, back into place. And finally, if you wish, you can push the disk tray back in, or you could simply provide a power feed to your device and it should retract on its own using the predetermined retract and the eject mechanism of your optical drive. Well, there you go. I'll leave you with that. I hope that information helps, and as usual, all the best.